The diagram shows a circle PQRS, PQRS, with center 0. The angle UQR, this is UQR, so we are concerned with the angle at the middle Q, okay, which is 68 degrees, equal to 68. The angle TPS equal to 74 degrees, that's TPS, that's the angle at the middle, which is P, is 74 degrees. And the angle QSR is 40 degrees. This is QSR. The angle at the middle, which is S, is 40 degrees. Calculate the value of the angle PRS. Let's mark that. PRS. This is P. This is R. This is R. And this is S here. So it means the angle at the middle, R. This is PRS. So it means we need to calculate this angle here. We need to calculate this angle here. Alright. This says calculate the value of the angle PRS. Now, anytime we see any question on geometry or algebra or any other thing, any other question like this in mathematics, the first thing that should come to our mind is we can solve the question. That should be the first thought that should be formed in your heart, that you can solve the question. Don't just think, oh, I can't solve it. First imagine in your heart that this question, I can solve it. Then you approach it like that. The first thing we need to do is to check a theorem. Let's say we have a circle like this, and we have a cyclic quadrilateral inside like this. We have a cyclic quadrilateral inside like this. You know, a quadrilateral is a four-sided shape, and this point here is extended outside like this, okay? If we have an angle here, let me use another color. Let's say we have an angle here like this, an exterior angle here as A. The angle opposite this exterior angle is equal to that angle. This is B. This B here is the angle opposite to the exterior angle. So there's a theorem in circle geometry that says the exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to the opposite interior angle. And this is what that means. If, for example, this place is extended like this, and we have an exterior angle, let's say C here, it means that this angle C here is equal to the opposite angle here. As if, for example, this angle is D. Okay, C here is equal to D. If, for example, C is 40 degrees, it means that the angle at D will be 40 degrees also. Okay, the exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to the opposite interior angle. Now, we'll use this to find our angle PRS. Now, you notice here that the angle RQU is 68 degrees. This angle here. The angle here is 68 degrees. It means we can use the same theorem to find the angle, to find the total angle here. The exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral, this is an exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral, this is a cyclic quadrilateral. The exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to the opposite interior angle. This angle here is the opposite interior angle. So it means that the angle PSR is equal to 68 degrees. We'll just say the angle PSR, the total angle at S here, PSR, is equal to 68 degrees. And this is still equal to the angle RQU. That is exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral equal to the opposite interior angle. That's how we got this. So here we can just say the angle PSR is equal to 68 degrees. Now, if the angle PSR is 68 degrees, it means that this angle here, we can easily calculate it. This angle here, PSQ, we can easily calculate. Let's say this angle here is B. Okay? It means that B plus 40 degrees is equal to the total angle there, which is 68 degrees. Then we can just say B equal to 68 degrees minus 40 degrees. Okay? This is B is equal to 68 minus 40 will give us 28 degrees. It means that the angle B here is 28 degrees. Now we have this side as 28 degrees. But you remember the theorem that says that angles in the same segment are equal. If, for example, we have a circle like this, And let's say we have something like this, we have something like this, we have something like this, okay? And let's say the center of the circle is here, for example. Okay, this is the center of the circle. Now, this angle here and this angle are in the same segment. If this is an angle A and this is an angle B, they are in the same segment. If, for example, you have angle C here and angle D here, these other angles, these two angles are in the same segment. It means that if C is 30 degrees, D is also going to be 30 degrees because the two angles are in the same segment. We'll apply the same concept here. Angles in the same segment are equal. Now, 0 here is the center of the circle. I could just mark this like this. I could just mark this like this. Now, the angle B here, PSQ, the angle B here is 28 degrees. Therefore, it means the angle here will also be 28 degrees because of angle in the same segment of a circle. Now, since this angle PRQ, this angle PRQ is 28 degrees, we can find the angle PRS, this angle here, we can find angle PRS. Now, what we'll just do is we'll apply the same theorem that says the exterior angle of a cyclic collateral is equal to the opposite interior angle. Now, you see this exterior angle here, this 74 degrees, is equal to the opposite interior angle, this one here. Everything there is equal to the opposite interior angle there. So, we could just say that the angle SPT is equal to that. The SPT 74 degrees is equal to the opposite interior angle, which is QRS, which is the sum of this angle 28 degrees plus the angle which you need here. So you say SPT, which is 74 degrees, is equal to QRS, which is 28 degrees plus the angle which we are looking for, PRS. This is P, then R, then S here, okay, plus the angle PRS. That's the exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to the opposite interior angle. Could just take 28 to the left hand side here, would have 74 degrees minus 28 degrees is equal to PRS. As PRS is equal to 74 minus 28 is definitely 46 degrees. So it means the angle PRS is equal to 46 degrees. Now, anytime you are given a question on circle geometry, the first thing you need to do is to look at the question critically and look at the sections where you can apply one theorem or the other to solve it. And once you understand which theorem to apply in any of the sections, you'll be able to solve the question.